pop fishing. And this week, actually, I had a few questions for, you know, some people as the ice season's coming around us. And a lot of people have been wondering, what kind of shack should I get? Especially if you're just getting into ice fishing, or even if you've been ice fishing for many years. The two main types of you know, ice shacks and everything that people use currently are, you know, quick pop-up ones or the flip-over ones. So let's have let's get Fishing Kit's ideas in regards to what he recommends and, you know, the pros and cons of that. So let's ask Fishing Kit real quick and see what he thinks in regards to that.
Can you give me the pros and cons to you? In your experience from a flip-over shanty or a pop-up hub? I mean, what are the pros and cons in your opinion?
With the flip-over, but I've used a couple here and there. But the biggest differences between those two are, you know, your pop-up, it's bigger. That means more room to fish, and you fit more people if you want to bring kids and whatnot. I mean, depending on how big of a pop-up you bring. Like, I have it says 4 to 5 people. I don't know if I'd fit 5 people in there. Like 3, I think I'd put 3 in there with our gear. I bring it out solo because, you know, since I make videos and stuff, the way I could just position my cameras wherever. The con with it is it's just unwieldy because, you know, you got your sled, then you got this long, I call it the body bag every time I drag it out, because it's like this 5 foot long, 6 foot long bag that I'm throwing in my sled, weighs like 60 pounds. That'd be like the biggest downside of it, like compared to a flip over. With the flip over, drag it, it is your sled. And then, you know, it's when you want to pick up and move, that is the big advantage of a flip over. With the pop up, you got to break it down, tie it up, then stick it in the bag. Then whenever you want to move, get up, take it out of the bag, pop it back out, set it up wherever, you know, wherever you're gonna fish. Well, I think at least with most flip overs is, okay, you wanna move, just flip over the top, drag it to wherever you wanna go. And then when you get to your spot, you just flip back over.
So as Fishing Kit was saying, there's so many pros and cons to both. I mean, let's start with the pop-up. In my opinion, I have a family, so the pop-up works really great for me. It's convenient in regards to having a lot of space and a lot of room to put all my gear inside. And of course, I have a thermal top and everything, so it helps when I have my small children with me, and that way they don't get too cold. And if you have a heater inside, you have plenty of room. I have multiple kids, so it definitely helps. And then also, if you have a group of friends that are coming out and ice fishing with you and having so much room, it's definitely convenient to have a pop-up. If you're looking to cook on the ice or just really be able to, it's a social thing in regards to having a pop-up tent. And then the cool thing about the pop-up tent, they literally just pop up. It's really simple. You just kind of anchor it down and it's pretty, it literally just pops up on the sides and it pops up on the top. There's many kinds. There's 5-man, 6-man. I carry an 8-man one, which is 2 shack, literally like 2 pop-up tents into one. So like I said, it gives you plenty of room. The only thing is, I would say the con in regard to the pop-up is that you're gonna be stationary. Once you set up, most likely you're not gonna want to run and gun type of thing if you're looking for fish. But if you're on top of fish, this is the perfect ideal setup in regards to, because most of these pop-up tents don't weigh more than, you know, 50 to 70 pounds at most. And they literally are like, you know, Fishing Kit was saying, there is like carrying a bag. You can literally put it on your backpack too. So that's the cool thing about the pop-ups. The negative side, as I said, you're stationary. And also it can be a hassle when it's windy. So when you're setting up your pop-up tent, it's windy. If you have another person to help you out, give you a helping hand, that will definitely help you. So as you can anchor down while you pop up the tent and everything, kind of hold it down. But other than that, the wind is going to be really difficult to set up a pop-up. It can be really tough in regards to that. But then the cool thing about the flips, not the flip-overs, the cool thing about the flip-overs that obviously they're meant to be mobile. And the good thing about those also is that it's literally your sled and your chair and seat, everything on one. And you literally can run and gun. So if you go one, you just find a spot, you drill a hole, you flip it over, and you're fishing. And then if there's no fish, you look at your fish finder, your flasher, you don't see anything, you can move on to, you know, 100 yards. Pretty simple. You just pick that back up, put your gear back on the sled, pull that sucker, and you can flip it back over, and then you're back to fishing again. Now, the other, I could say, the con in regards to the flip over is that you're gonna need a truck, because when you have a flip over, it's large. Most likely, you're gonna need some type of a pickup truck to pull that, or even some people, you know, use trailers to pull it. In regards to the pop-up, the cool thing about that is, like I said, it fits like a backpack, so you can throw it into an SUV, even a small vehicle, you know, sedan. You can literally take a pop-up tent with you if you want to go ice fishing. So those are the pros and cons. You got kind of have to figure it out. A lot of people use the flip up, especially if you're a tournament guy or a tournament gal, if you look at the ice fishing tournaments, so that way you can run and gun. I highly recommend the flip over. If you have a family, like I said, if you're going to be stationary, highly recommend the pop up. Both of them has, you know, the pros and cons. What I recommend also is cost effectiveness. If you're looking to get into ice fishing and cost is an issue, pop-up is the way to go. They're going to be way, way cheaper in regards to that. And then what I always say is, if you get the pop-up, maybe a year or two down the road, you want to get the flip, keep that pop-up for days that you want to be stationary, days you want to be social or have a family, and then days that you're by yourself or you have another buddy, you can use the flip over if you have enough money saved in the next, you know, year or two. So I highly recommend doing that also. All the new pop-ups now and all the new flipboards, most of them are all thermal, so that's gonna help in regards to retention of heat and everything inside, and so you shouldn't have to worry too much about that. But there's so many brands out there. I highly recommend just going to Google, look it up, do the research. YouTube, obviously, you can see all the different types of brands and the pros and cons on that, and really just go to forums and really talk to people. And I highly recommend actually just going to your local store. If you go to your local bait shop or local ice fishing stores, they should be able to let you test it out, see it, and also on top of that, they should be able to have some great knowledge. So I highly recommend going to your local bait shop. They should be able to give you, you know, in the right direction. If you tell them what you're looking for, whether a pop-up or a flipboard, that's the route to go. So other than that, like I said, there's so many pros and cons. I wouldn't say there's one way better than the other. It's just honestly preference. So there you go. That gives you guys a little bit in regards to the flipboard and the pop-up. Ice season's coming up, so make sure you guys get on it and, you know, get your shelter ready, and let's get on the ice. Thanks, guys.